curtains. He likes red for breakfast. And then there's... Maybe we'll go there, Firefly. This one was about the history of spoons. A little boring. This last one is my favorite! So glad I didn't lose it. The rocky cliff face posed no challenge to her now. Whee! The sacred bell to announce her arrival.
Oh, thank you, thank you. Never thought I'd be so glad to see my feet again.
I heard Mum crying in her room. She looked so ill. Gran is going to get better, right? Mum was so worried. What if... A glow in the sand. I'll get you safely home, my little friend. Another firefly escaped from the dragon's grasp. Hey there, little one. You're safe now. Heart, clothes, mouth. Hold on, fireflies. Hold on. Your help?
I said go!
Maybe sand swimming dead. of the ages filled the air.
Fresh air! Foul-tempered voice drifted down to Robin. But the Desert Guardian would not let it rest.
Hey! Stop it!
What happened to them? Who were they? The ancient statues toppled before Robin.
That's better. I do the magic around here.
The Desert Guardian was frantically looking for Robin.
Stop hiding from me!
He would surely find her eventually.
Must leave. It must. They mustn't know.
What is it with this guy? Thank you.
Not at the car park. Not during our drive home. Dad had made pies for tea. I just wasn't hungry. Dad said I needed to eat. I said, if Gran wasn't going to eat, neither would I. He sent me to my room.
Magic gently released her into the unknown.
Now where am I?
Stone. She'd seen nothing like this in her forest home.
I really miss my reading nook.
Stalactites hung above, looking decidedly precarious. Unnerving about the pendulum.
I knew it.
The lava gently bubbled, as if to mock her lack of progress. Robin was adrift on the current. Without control. Lost on the flow of lava. It would take her where it wished. Burning river went faster. And faster. And then I did the washing up from breakfast. Dad said,
"Home, you miss it?"
"Yes, that's why I'm doing this."
"You miss home, but you..."
Help, Lump.
Lump, small. Lump, no use.
You used to be a lot bigger.
Yes, yes!
rush. That was amazing. Something strong and very, very large had been here recently.
Look! One of them little glowy things you likes.
Wood for Elder Reaver. I hope it's still okay. The loss of Lump weighed heavily upon her. The lake looked murky, but she had to brave its depths. I've never seen a dead body before. It might be scary. Right? Maybe I should have stayed at home. How do I get up there? Thank you. bending with almost malicious intent.
I need to get out of here. Breathe, Robin. Breathe. I've got to find the dragon. Get back the fireflies. Beautiful, and now... broken. It grows back, right? Dragon to find. I have to focus on that. No matter what. She spoke those words. But deep in her heart, chilling doubt took root. The color gave way to darkness, endless and all. Air? No matter what. A cold determination gripped her. A seekin, encased in ice. Oh no! What have I done? I'm so sorry. Please forgive me. I never wanted this. I should never have come.
What would Elder Ava think of me? I'm so selfish!
It would not leave her. It would not cease.
Leave me alone! Anything. Yeah. Word, madam. Like cutting through.
She felt that she could touch the sky.
After what I've been through, you really think that will stop me?
Thank you.
Nothing's moving. Must be more to do. A gust of fresh air rewarded Robin's efforts. As she rose up the stairs, waiting. There you are! And here I come! For the first time, Robin felt no fear. She knew she had all she needed.
Feels warm on my soles.
Before her, a molten sea stretched into the distance. It did not slow her down. Suddenly, Robin no longer felt the heat. In its stead, a cold dread crept up her spine.
This can't be real. A trick. I can't let it be real.
She gripped the chain with furious determination. I know you're there! Oh... I hope you can forgive me. Torn between rage and regret. Finally, Robin readied herself for a confrontation.